Okay, it's been cleaned to within an inch of its life, or a centimeter if you're in metric. And then I've rubbed my graphite-y finger all over the interior surfaces. And it's not exactly airtight. It's running backwards, but it's probably enough to run. This, after many years of not really working, I've tried to get all the old oil and graphite and stuff out of this and see if we can get this going again before I give up and re-bore and re-piston the thing.
I think that's actually going to work pretty well once you have the back off that. So that's one option for me.
So this one, actually, I think it's just too big. So I've got to cut this to the right length and make a piston.
How are you going to cut it without blowing up the whole thing?
You're supposed to be able to cut glass with a grinder,
yeah,
carefully,
yeah,
if you put water on it. So let's just check whether this will fit. It looks like it might be quite a good fit. 26.3, and the outer diameter of this is 26.3. You've got to be kidding me. 26.1. So that's going to actually slide into there absolutely perfectly with a little bit of heatsink compound. Oh, I might be able to repair this myself. 26.1. So that's just nuts. Okay. All right, good to know, good to know. Now, can I make a Stirling engine with this massive great thing? Holy moly. I'm just going to put some meths in here. Now, this meths I'm using has none of that bittering agent and colouring agent that you associate with trying to stop alcoholics from drinking it. It's also illegal to sell in New Zealand, but they did sell it at Bunnings a while ago, and I've saved it just for use with my flame-sucking engines. Just remember, we need to preheat this again. When I first got this, I didn't preheat it. It used to gum up, and all the graphite used to, you know, turn itself into a paste, which then scoured the piston. I also like to run this at breakneck speed, which is another way to, you know, destroy it, I guess, especially when it's only got an aluminium bore and an aluminium piston. Righty-ho. I'm using fiberglass wick. Nearly working, isn't it? Bring this up here. Right, bigger flame, much bigger flame. think this wick might be just a bit tight, actually. Oh, no, that's a bigger flame. Let's see if that works. I mean, that's what they do in the YouTube videos, but I do not like having it that big. That's a way, isn't it? We'll just see what happens. Generally, I run my my flame sucking vacuum engines on a lot less, flame than this. Away, isn't it? That's pretty cool. Hasn't run properly for a long time. We'll just see if we can run it on a little bit less flame, keep it a little bit cooler. Nice. It's a bloody gorgeous day here in Christchurch, New Zealand. For a change, it's been pretty manky. Now, I'm in the last stages of rehabilitating this old engine that, when I say old, oh, I don't know, 10 years old or so, came from James Maiwald in Germany. The big problem, well, there's no great problem. This is rattling like a bastard, so I'm looking at ways to fix that. What I'm hoping is that this this hole that's threaded through here goes all the way through, and I can stick a brass screw down there and stop that rattling around. Look, I mean, I know I'm obsessive about some of these things, but that's just what I want to do. I don't want it to rattle. I want it to run as well as possible. I don't think that goes all the way down to the hole. I wish it did. Okay, so zoom you guys in a bit. I've manned up and disconnected this. I'm still fearing that I'm never going to get that straight again. This is the problem. That elongated bit there is going rattle, rattle, rattle like a bastard when I get this lovely engine to run. So we're going to put a threaded hole in the middle of that so we can press a bit of brass against there and, yeah, adjust it. My first vacuum engine, one of the first engines in my collection. This is a 2012 engine from James Maiwald. Ordered off James's website to have a water tank on the front, which I've removed in the last few days. Put this better passive heat sink there. The water tank wasn't very effective. It was messy. I think passive heating is the way to go. This needed a very thorough clean, and we'll see if we can get it working. Noticed when I did get it working that this was rattling terribly, so I've put a bit of brass in here up against that. That doesn't rattle anymore. I've rubbed graphite powder thoroughly into the cylinder and piston, as well as this PC heatsink. I've put this here to stop the flame going into that PC heatsink. Let's get our hairdryer, and we're going to see if we can get this going. I believe one of the reasons that this wore out the piston and cylinder as bad as it did was because I didn't know anything about preheating them. So although I was using graphite on the piston and cylinder, they would sort of muck up into this watery mess when the first of the meth's flame went into here. It would condense, and the cold cylinder cause all this. Yeah, it was just a mess, and I think that's what that contributed to this wearing. First run after the new bearing. I also think that these might need to come away a little bit. I'll show you what I mean. This valve likes to flap around a bit. See what I mean? I think we need to change the position of this, actually. That's what I'm seeing there. That's what I'm hearing there. A little bit of suction at the end. So, the valve. Oh, that was all the difference. Let's just do that back up. As you see, timing of the valve on this thing can be pretty crucial. As, of course, is where this is. Yeah, and you get that if you put it too close. Wow. Hey, that was pretty good. Well, that sounds really nice. It's got a completely new sound because the big end isn't going bang, 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 bang. This is hot. That's too hot to touch. And those two are cooling, which is what it should be. I keep the overall temperature down with this one. Should be hotter here than here. Just light that back up again. We might just get a little bit more speed out of that. Although we don't want to wear it out, but hey, these things are born to... Want to run, huh?
Yep, so it's starting to wear in. Running low.